Well, good morning, my children.
Good morning, Daddy.
And good morning to all of our friends out there. Welcome to
Connected Kids!
Welcome to Connected Kids. This is the Children's Church of Connected Church. I am joined once again by my children. Good morning, Ariella.
Good morning, Father.
Good morning, Daniel.
Good morning, Daddy.
And happy Sunday. Happy Sunday, indeed. It is a happy Sunday because, as some of you may have realized, we didn't record service last week. We didn't have Children's Church last week because Mommy and Daniel were in quarantine. They were in isolation. We did have a slight COVID-19 scare, but praise be to God, we have come out of it and everyone is healthy and safe. And after 2 weeks of quarantining alone in our bedroom, Mommy and Daniel have finally been able to interact with the rest of the family. And as you can see, Ella and Daniel are very excited to be together once again. So, with that being said, who would like to pray this morning? Awesome. Daniel, pray nice and loud. Use your big boy voice and pray for our service this morning.
Lord, we hope
nice and loud, buddy.
Okay. Lord, we hope we have a nice, good Sunday, and that we can all have a nice day, and that we all don't have to go through what we had to go through, which was isolation and not having to be doing Children's Church because I was out. And we pray that everyone has a safe day. In Jesus' name, we pray.
Amen. Awesome. And so, because this is our Christmas Children's Church, we have a very special Christmas worship song. This is Jesus, Oh What a Wonderful Child. It comes from Cedarmont Kids. This is their gospel Christmas songs. You can find it on YouTube, and here we go. Jesus, what a wonderful
Jesus,
child.
Jesus, Jesus.
Okay, yes. Jesus, what a wonderful child. What a beautiful song, and we're so grateful. So, who knows, what are we celebrating this week? Ariella.
Christmas.
And what do we celebrate at Christmas? Daniel.
Jesus being born.
The birth of our Savior, Jesus Christ. So we want to look at something very specific about that, and it comes from the book of Luke. We're not going to bang the table, please. We're going to read Luke chapter 1. And, you know, what's interesting, guys, is Daddy is going to be talking about a part of this scripture in adult church today, too. So the adults are going to learn what you guys are discussing today as well. So that's pretty cool. So we're going to be looking at just believe God does impossible things. And if you're following along again, let me actually share my screen so you can see. We are looking at, once again, we are getting our text from sundayschool.works, and this is their Christmas lesson, where we're actually looking at the awesome things, the mighty things, the miraculous things that God did, not only for Mary, but also Mary's cousin. We learned about someone a couple weeks ago, guys. Do you remember who we learned about a couple weeks ago? Ella, who did we learn about a couple weeks ago?
I actually don't remember, but I do know that Mary's cousin also had a baby, too.
Yeah,
almost at the same time around.
Her baby was born earlier, but yeah, they were close. They were close. They weren't years apart. Do you remember Mary's cousin's name? The woman that was also pregnant with Mary. Daniel.
Oh, I can't remember.
Daniel, you can try first.
Was it the girl that walked with the other girl to Bethlehem?
Nope. Ella, what's her name?
She went with Naomi.
No, you're thinking of Ruth, but Ruth was alive long before Mary and her cousin. Her cousin's name was Elizabeth. Elizabeth. Uh-huh. And so Elizabeth was pregnant around the time that Mary was. Elizabeth actually got pregnant first. And Elizabeth's pregnancy was also a miracle. Why? Does anyone know why Elizabeth's pregnancy was also a miracle? Daniel, why was Elizabeth's pregnancy also a miracle?
Because it was John the Baptist. No.
Your sister gave you a good hint. So, who was her son? Who did she give birth to?
Jesus.
No, not Elizabeth. Elizabeth gave birth to who?
John the Baptist.
Yes, Elizabeth gave birth to John the Baptist. What did we learn about John the Baptist? What did John the Baptist do? Ella.
He made a way for Jesus coming.
He told everyone that Jesus was coming, yeah. And what? And do we also do something similar to John the Baptist?
Yes.
Daniel.
We show people, we tell people about God.
Yeah, we tell people about how Jesus is coming back. So John the Baptist told everyone about how Jesus was coming the first time, and we get to tell everyone about how Jesus is coming back. That's one of the great things that we do. So Elizabeth gave birth to John the Baptist. I hope we're all paying attention. I know we're excited to be together. Elizabeth gave birth to John the Baptist, but the miracle was in that Elizabeth actually couldn't have babies. Elizabeth's body had a issue with it, and so she wasn't actually able to have babies. But God did a miracle and gave Elizabeth much later in her life the ability to have a baby. And God sent an angel to tell her husband, Zachariah, that they were going to have this miraculous baby. So Elizabeth has a miraculous baby whose name is?
John the Baptist!
And then her cousin,
Mary,
has a miraculous baby whose name is?
Jesus!
Yeah, Mary has a miraculous baby too. So we're going to read about Mary's miraculous, the miracle and the miraculous birth. So if you're reading along with me, friends and family, we're going to go to Luke, the first chapter, the 26th verse. We're looking at the blueletterbible.org is where we're reading from. That's what's on the screen. And so we're going to Luke chapter 1, verse 26. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God to the city of Galilee named Nazareth to a virgin who was betrothed, that means she was engaged, to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her, the angel, and said, "Greetings, O favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at the saying, and tried to understand what sort of greeting this might be. And the angel said to her, "Don't be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God." That means God really likes you. "And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus. And he will be great, and he will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom," Jesus' kingdom, "there will be no end." And Mary said to the angel, "How will this be? Since I am still a virgin, I haven't spent time with my husband." And the angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child will be born, will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, has conceived a son in the sixth month with her who was called barren," meaning that she couldn't have any children. Here's the key verse. We're going to remember this. So remember Luke chapter 1, verse 37. So repeat after me. Luke chapter 1,
verse
37. For nothing will be impossible
with God.
Very good.
Not
say it one more
time.
Yes, this is your verse from school. Luke chapter 1,
will be chapter impossible,
verse 37.
For
nothing
will be impossible with God.
Very good.
I was trying to show you this. We'll
do it again at the end.
So
we know that with God nothing is impossible, which is why Mary, who was young, and even though she was supposed to be married, she wasn't yet married to her husband, so they didn't have a baby together. And Elizabeth, who was much older and couldn't have a baby, these two women both had these miraculous babies. They had these miraculous births because nothing is impossible with God. And that's what we want to celebrate. And in particular, what we want to remember about Christmas is it's not just there was this sweet baby who was born in a manger, who was born in a barn, and all the animals were around, and the three kings came to visit him, and the shepherds came to visit, and there were angels, and all that is really cool. But what we really want to remember and focus on about this holiday season is that God can do miraculous things. Nothing is impossible with God. What do you guys think?
It's good. And Ella, I was trying to show you the symbols. For nothing will be impossible with God. I was just going to
Right. So that is what we want to remember and celebrate, especially about this Christmas season, is not only was Jesus born, but that Jesus' birth and John's birth are these lasting symbols that nothing is impossible with God. So what we're going to do, my friends, is we are going to head over and prepare for our craft. I'm going to show my friends at home what we're going to be working on. Today's craft project is the angel plate. The angel plate. Very exciting. My children have not seen it yet, so they are a little confused, but that's okay. So for my friends at home, again, Sunday School Works, this is what we're going to be doing. You'll want some material to decorate the plate, markers, crayons, etc. You'll need some glue, coffee filters if you have it, or tissue paper. And as you can see, we're going to be decorating the plate and turning the plate into angels. So that's what we're going to be doing for our craft project today. We are going to step away and prepare to do the craft with Ella and Daniel, and then we'll come back for our recap. All right, so how did those angels come out?
8.
Looking pretty good. Can we see your angels?
11,
12. Ella's angels. Daniel, can we see your angel? Very interesting indeed. All right, so who can recap? Who were the two women that had miraculous births? Daniel, name one of the women that had a miraculous birth.
Mary.
Mary. And who did Mary give birth to?
Jesus.
And Ella, who was the other woman?
Elizabeth, and she gave birth to John the Baptist.
And how were Mary and Elizabeth related?
They were cousins.
They were cousins, yeah.
And also,
yeah.
They both had miraculous babies, and that's another way they were.
Well, but that's not how they were related. That may be something they have in common, but they were related because they were cousins. And so we celebrate Jesus' birth at Christmas, but what else do we focus on? What did we learn about today that we should keep in mind for Christmas? Daniel and then Ariella.
Jesus' birth.
Right, but we focus on something else in addition to that. Yes, Ella.
Therefore, nothing is impossible with God.
Nothing is impossible with God. So, Daniel, what's our memory verse?
For nothing will be impossible with God.
Ella, do you remember where that comes from for a special bonus?
I know it was chapter 1, verse 36.
Very good. So not John, but
Luke.
Very good, guys. Awesome. So remember, everyone, as we go into celebrate this very special season, one, we want to make sure that everyone stays healthy and safe. It's a great time of the year. There's a lot to celebrate. But as you're celebrating, remember that this is not only about Jesus' birth, but that this season is about the enduring legacy of the miraculous things God can do. For with God, nothing is impossible. Thank you all so much for joining us once again. Let's close out, family.
Stay safe, stay healthy, and stay in this fight.
God bless, everyone. Take care. Bye-bye.